part two of the Embird Studio puzzle motif. Are you guys ready for this? Let's do it. Hey everybody and welcome back. My name is Sue and I am from OML Embroidery. And today we are going to be working on this puzzle motif. Now there is a part one to this and I showed you guys how to set it up, but I forgot to do two things. So you'll need to go back and do it the right way. I forgot to turn it. You can see here at the bottom that it has to be on an angle. I totally forgot. And I added a line across here just to make it easier. Now, if you don't feel like going back, because I know you guys know how to, you know, put everything together, I will put the BMP for this in the OML Embroidery University Facebook group just to make it a little easier for you guys, because it was my mistake. Oh well, my bad, it happens. So let's get to creating this awesome puzzle motif. We need to get moving on into Studio. So the easiest way to do it here is just click. All right, now we're in Studio and now we are gonna do this puzzle motif. So we need to go up here and this is called user editors, and there's a lot of things you can do in this user editor. So this is making programmed fill stitches, so tatami or fill stitches, and you can play around with that. It's actually kind of cool what you can come up with. And this is the motif. And this is for borders, so you can make your own borders as well. But for now, let's go to the create a motif. Outlines. I had to look up what this meant. Outlines and motifs. I'm used to having motifs that you could use as, you know, a single line or a fill, but Embird doesn't do it that way. So outlines is just for outlining. So a specific motif to outline, and motif is what we're thinking, you know, filling in on the inside. Make sure that you have the motif part selected, because I don't think the puzzle piece is going to look very good as an outline. I don't think it's going to line up. So that's the first thing. And with motif selected, none of this is available. Shift we can do, but we can also do that in parameters. And you don't have to worry about anything else. We are going to name it puzzle piece. Let's bring in our image. So this button here says import image into background, and that's exactly what we want. And we want to do the puzzle, I think it's puzzle two in mine. I played around with it quite a bit. And again, I will add that into the OML Embroidery University group to save you the trouble, because it was my boo-boo. All right, so the way that the motifs work, you have to think more of like in a sewing machine. It has to go in one motion. It has to start here and it has to end there. So this is your start and this is your end. And you'll see if you bring it in too much, there's going to be spaces between the motifs, and that's not what we want. So this, keep in mind, this is, you know, a pretty complicated motif. You're kind of, you know, if you move it around like this, this motif would take you like 2 seconds to do, and that's easy. This is a little more complicated, but don't be afraid of it either, because it's really doable. And if you, you know, take the time to work on it, then it's not so bad. So just playing around, I've added a few in there. What you have to do is click on the node to move it and make sure it's activated. And I want another node in here. So I'm going to click here and then click here. So you have to get the rhythm of it as well. So I'm actually going to put one more in here and kind of move it back. So this is a little bit of precision work. And it's a little bit fiddly, and you want to try not to put 10 gazillion nodes in here, but it's also not that hard. The more time you put into it, you only have to do it once, and it's pretty cool when it's done. So the key to this one, as I'm working my way around, is the angle of the puzzle piece. And I drew that red line through the middle of it so it would make it easier to line everything up. See how fast I'm going now? Because I'm getting the rhythm of it. If you start off like I did, and I was clicking all the wrong ones, and it was making a bit of a mess, then you just stop and activate the one that you want. So, and also remember too that this is a small design, the motif. You can make them bigger later, but this one that you're digitizing is quite small, so make sure you're keeping that in mind. Okay, so now we have gone from the front, the start, to finish. Now that's only half a puzzle. So what you have to do is you can either continue down here and then go back on it, or continue down here and go here so your last node is here. Either way, you could even actually go back on this one and that would work too. So I don't think it really matters, so make sure this is still our last stitch. So I moved it up a little bit just to remind me that it's my last stitch. Now, this part like this might get a little confusing, but just remember what you're doing. Now you can click here. Once you get past that little curve there, it's not too bad. If you get a little mixed up, all you have to do is just get it straightened out, and the darkest node here is the one that's activated, so the next one in line. Also note, I don't know if you noticed, but there aren't any curved nodes as far as I know. All the right-click options that you get is insert and delete nodes. Whoops, I clicked twice by accident, but that's okay. This is how you do it. So we're getting there, and the next step is going to be that we have to go back on this so we don't want to start and end in the same spot. If we do that, we're going to end up with a jump stitch in between them, and that is going to ruin our cute puzzle, so we don't want to do that. So this is the best way to do it. If you don't care and you want a line in there, by all means, go ahead. So now I've finished the puzzle piece. That looks great. And you can see up here and you can see down here the jump stitches. So we don't really want that. I think that takes a lot away from the design, but now all we have to do is go back again. Now these are just running stitches, single stitches, so it doesn't really matter that we're going over one part twice. There's not really any other way of doing it, so this one works out just fine this way. So here we go, here we go. Now this going back is a lot easier because I am just going to click and I'm going to put the nodes where the other ones are so it matches up perfectly. Again, take your time. It would be a lot better if they match literally perfectly. And you can also zoom in and zoom out and make sure your stitches are looking good. And are on top of each other. You can see over here if you look closely. I have missed a few. I'm not going to worry about it, but you should take the time to make it really good. If you're wondering how everything's going, you either look down here, this is what the fill is going to look like, or up here, and you can see that the jump stitch is going on. That's not in the right spot. So the more as you put nodes down, you can really see the puzzle piece coming together. Now I'm going to move this one a little bit, and then I need to reactivate that one. So when I click on here, there we go, just so you don't get mixed up. And we're going to put this one just inside, and I would like another one just for precision. I think I did just fine. If you look down here, you can see, yeah, awesome. Now we don't need to mess with the shift. Everything looks great. This here is a slow redraw, and I mean slow. It's really slow, really slow. So I'm not going to do that because it's painfully slow. And what we want to do is save. Now, when you click save, it is going to ask you to save it in the patterns. And it's saving it as a special ESM file, which is the motif. Now, when I went to go save it in here, it tells me that I don't have authority to do that, which is hilarious, but these are locked down so you don't mess them up. So you can save it anywhere that you want. I made a little file folder on my desktop, which is just handy for making the videos. You can save it, in a motif folder if you want. Either way, just save it so you can do it. There's puzzle, and I already have one, but I named it something different, so that's okay. So we've saved it. We're good. Let's click OK. Again, make sure it's motif and not an outline. And this, doesn't it look cute? I love it. So let's go to OK. And why don't we make something and test it out? So I clicked on this here, which is we're going to make an object with a fill. And I'm going to use a shape, and you have to click a node down, then go to shape. And we could just do a big circle because we want it to look great. I'm going to hold down the control to make it a perfectly constrained circle and let go. And then you need to right click on here and go to elements. And you notice once I did all that, it is done. So let's generate some stitches for that. We are looking good. Zoom out a little bit and here we are. How big is this guy? 3x3. Our puzzle pieces might be a little bit small or large. So let's go all the way. Let's make a bigger hoop. So just pick anyone that's bigger. Apply. There we go. Now we have a little more room. So let's bring it out. All you have to do is drag it out. We're doing a working file, so we can make it as big or as small as we want. Okay, that looks good. That's awesome. That should be big enough. So let's go to the parameters, and this opened up just a little outside of your view, and we want to go to motif. And I went into this a couple times and I'm like, where is my puzzle? Where is it? Okay, go up. It's there. It took me a minute or so to figure that out. And if you want to see how it looks, click apply. And that is a lot of tiny puzzle pieces. So what we want to do is make it a little bit larger. So I'm just clicking on here. Now nothing happens until you click apply. It's looking better. I think we could do a little bit more. Little bit more. There we go. Click apply. That's as far as it goes. And remember, this is quite big, so that it's like 6x6. So almost a mug rug, I think. I really like how this looks. Now, we can also add an effect to it. So we can do a wave. So down here, right here, wave. And this may look difficult, but it's really easy. All you have to do is left click, and I'm holding it down and moving this line. So you could even do, let's see, up like this. Of course, nothing will happen till you click apply. And once I click apply, look, And it goes with the curvature of the circle. So you can change it to anything that you want. And you know what? Play around with it. That is a really nice effect. And let's try it this way, maybe to the extreme. Let's do that. Yes, isn't that awesome? So you can play around with the wave effect and get it exactly how you love it. And I kind of like that one. That one's not too bad. Maybe too extreme. So apply. And that is looking great. Let's generate the stitches and deselect it. Let's look at it in 3D. I like it. Isn't that nice? Now you can see because I didn't do it perfectly, but one part of it is a little bit thicker than the other. But when you stitch it out, it really isn't going to show that well. And I would do another circle of maybe even just running stitches or satin stitches to fill out the gaps there and make it look better. But for now, that's how we do it. So this has been a two-part series of how to do these amazing puzzle motifs. So once you've saved the EOF, you're now here in Editor and is looking great. And here you want to make sure on your way here that you save it as whatever file that you want. So PES is what I'm going to do. And then you can stitch it out or play around with it. It's a really fun design and it looks really good. Take your time in doing the puzzle pieces, the plotting out. Remember how they have to start and finish. And you'll be able to do this. So I am looking forward to everyone posting their puzzle pieces, hopefully with a little wave in them that looks really good, and different sizes and different size circles, or how about different shapes? So have fun creating your motif, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!